Hello there, 13. Containing I. I'm game teasing awesome. And welcome back to Insound Mind. Last episode, well, we took care of the woman there. And I forgot to pick up the paper. We also do a little bit of exploring.
Delicious.
Is going to be extremely useful. And I do mean extremely useful, especially for the buzzing around the apartment here.
Is there a link between Virginia and Alan? I wouldn't rule it out.
I guess I'm about to find out.
Be careful, Desmond.
Here we go again.
Come back alive, please.
I do like how this is like the trend.
Okay, Mr. Shore, tape's running. Thank you for agreeing to be recorded.
Should I just start talking? What do you want to know?
What made you decide to seek counseling?
Ah, man, Doc, it's just weird. As in, I feel weird, like I'm weird all the time, you know? I'm not saying this right. People think I'm weird, and it's cool I am, but I shouldn't feel weird, right?
How exactly do you feel weird?
Off? Odd? Slightly tilted? I've had these nightmares ever since I can remember. I've always had these horrific dreams I can't explain. And they recur. Man, like there are themes in them that keep coming back. And honestly, Doc, it's been such a constant that I shape my life around them, you know?
Have you ever seen anyone about these recurring nightmares?
Like a shrink? Like you? No. Honestly, for the longest time, I thought it was normal life to wake up sweating, to see things in the dark, frightful things.
What is it that frightens you, Alan?
See, that's the thing I don't get. My whole life, I could feel the presence of shadows. I could hear sorrow in the dark. It's poetic, man. I know. I got so used to being paralyzed by dread that I began to like it. And people notice, you know, I say weird stuff sometimes, I guess. At some point, I just decided to live comfortably in this reality, maintaining a beacon of light over a sea of darkness, alone and afraid. But I'd be lying if I didn't admit that being swallowed by darkness or sinking in the depths. It makes me feel alive, man. It's electric.
That's a hint as to what you're about to see. Now, one thing I'll make mention of, the lighthouse is the key, but as well, it's also going to be one of your biggest enemies, at least in terms of this one. So this is somewhat of a walkthrough, I should say. If y'all gonna use Noclip, be careful. Sense that you can bug the game out. I found out myself. Thank you. Bye. And there's your big enemy. That sweeping red light. That will actually damage you and not the enemy. I love the joke. I just got the joke right at the end of the tunnel. Nice joke. It pretty much only just does 5 points of damage. What's this stuff? Oh, I think a headshot. That legitimately. Now I have 115 health. We're coming back here. I need to check something. Okay, but just looking to see if I can find what happened to the flare gun. Find the flare gun is going to be necessary.
No, thank you.
And I believe I've somehow stunned it. The achievement for that, if you do it, it's called Take That. Yeah, I think I've stunned it.
is off. It's an old oil lantern.
Let me tell you, that guy is actually somewhat hard, but just bunny hop. Your flashlight will not cut it. I gotta get the fuses.
It's a fuse box.
There we go. We're going back.
I'll gotta show you something.
Now I must get it. Something there.
It's a base for a crank wheel. Pops out if I turn it too tight. It's a base for a crank wheel. It pops out if I turn it too tight. I should sit in the boat first.
Why would you sit in the boat first?
Bon voyage!
Ah!
definitely were outweighing of the life, and we don't have to worry about that. Not go in the water! The water is poisonous! What are these? Water over there. Never got that in the Wizard of Playfield, by the way.
No, thank you.
I don't know that if you go too far in the water, you die on that, or you take damage. I don't know. What? Now, we get a little bit of, Wow, that was...
Here goes nothing.
This insta-kills ink blots. However, be careful. Even though I'm playing it with a code, ammo for these things are sparse. So use it only when you have to. If enough, we don't have to go for that weird. That does not sound good.
Good.
I know what was gonna happen. Oh, that localized. What the fuck? Okay.
Thank you.
It's blocked from the other side. Yep, that's in my system now. Not bad. This way leads to the top of the crane.
Well, I know he's gonna come here. Oh, and noticing with the ink blocks is that they always drop, well, not always, but they'll. They'll drop health items. So don't be afraid to pick them up when need be. One thing I think this game should have, think about it. The next thing that this game should have is to be a quick save system. Two ways. Neither be on the crane or be here. I believe if I'm here, Kobe! I forgot about that. I forgot that he moves the crane. Essentially, go into the cabin, you'll be fine.
Side.
under to my ass.
Something stops me from getting closer. It's blocked from the other side.
Them over time. Well, in that case, I'm gonna end the episode here. When we come back, we'll traverse more of this warp of the Get Out, and maybe even replace the light. Until then, subscribe if you want to check out other videos I've done in the past, or to stay tuned for future videos on the channel. Comment down below what you think of this game, or if you have another game you want me to check out on the channel, so let me know down below. Until next time, stay 20% cooler, and I'll see you in the next video, my friends. Bye bye.